All right, so aggregation reports. Click the bottom right button here that says Agg Report. And now you want to pick on the situation that you want to look at. And this will be across a bunch of different boards. So you probably want to be extra careful to make sure that you've built your tree correctly. Otherwise, you'll just end up running a bunch of sims that don't actually look the way you want it to look, but that will also be a good learning exercise anyway. So I'm selected button versus small blind free bet pot. I've selected these ranges here based on the pre-flop library. And now you want to look at which boards you actually care about. If you want to just have a good understanding of how every board plays, then you want to run a large board subset. Otherwise, you can actually go and narrow this down. So let's say we want to look at, okay, how do we play monotone boards? We can click here, and this will just use one of our pre-built in subsets that only contain monotone boards. Next, you want to select your tree sizes. So here, if we just look at some of the recommended sizes, they're not ideal here because they're a little bit too big for a monotone board. But you can actually test out whether what I'm saying is true by running a subset yourself. But on these boards, often you might see something like a 10% pot sizing, a 25%, and maybe as big as 50, but like rarely all in. All in is just not used very often. And in terms of raise sizes, I'm going to give these options for each player. So this should be pretty reasonable for in position and out of position play. You have enough like check raise and raise versus c-bet sizes, and this will give you a pretty good output. But with solvers, it really comes down to experimenting. You're going to run some sims that just give you some really weird answers and you won't get anything out of it. But that's also always just something that you learn. So you eventually over time you learn out what sizes are good, what sizes are bad. Sometimes you don't include a size and completely changes the strategy. But there you go, running our flop report. So this usually goes pretty quickly, much faster than what you would see using other tools to run Agg reports. So you can see we've already run four flops. And by the end of this video, all of these flops will be done. So let's have a look at one that's already run. So something like King Jack 7. In diamonds, you just click the little hat there to go into the actual flop strategy. And we can see that on this board, we're checking 75% of the time. When I'm studying monotone, I like to use the divided blocks feature. Since we can kind of dial in what we're doing with different hands, so for example, if we look at the diamond hands here, you can see that our queen six of suited is checking. A bunch of our nut flushes with a high kicker are checking, so ace queen, ace 10 is checking a bit as well, ace 8 is betting a bit more frequently. And highlighting over the combos, we can see ace 10 of diamonds betting very frequently, whereas 10 of diamonds not betting so often. Now, we've looked at some sims already, so let's go back to the Agg report function to just really show what's going on. So here we've got our 19 flop monotone subset. And what are we going to do with this? Well, we can look at this board subset in terms of check frequency by clicking the check and sorting it from highest to lowest. So we can see that on ace queen 10 and 7-3 deuce, we're doing almost no checking. Betting this 10% pot size really often. And compared to something like Ace King 6 or King Jack 7, where we're checking a bit more often. To understand why that's happening, you'll have to actually look into the sims. But to give you a hint, it's to do with how often each player has a flush or a flush draw, as well as how often they flop a pair with a flush draw. So 7-3 deuce, betting very frequently because the player free betting has all of the not flush draws, has a lot of overpairs, so the caller misses this board a lot, and the small C bet does the job. Alright, so let's say we C bet 10% pot. We're almost never getting a fold here, which is meant to be the case because, I mean, realistically, you're not really going to fold to such a small bet. But you can see that a hand like Queen 10 of clubs here is actually indifferent. So this is a pretty good size to use against people that aren't aware of how wide you have to call, because this bet is almost like a check. But we can also see, let's say we size up to 1/4. Okay, well now those hands are folding. So have a look at some different ag reports, run a bunch of spots, do some comparisons between bet sizes, so what boards are bet most frequently, what boards are checked most frequently, which boards we have a larger sizing, so for example, where do we use 1/4 a bit more than 10%? And this will give you a good idea of how to play across different board textures. So happy studying, hope you enjoyed this video.